If you need to test whether a battery is fully charged or flat, most people will suggest using a multimeter. If you know what you're doing, using a multimeter is very simple. Plug the red probe into the voltage port, the black into common or earth, select 0 to 20 volts DC on the dial, and then connect the red probe to the positive terminal and the black probe to the negative terminal, and you get a readout in volts. So this is showing we've got 8.92 volts across this 9 volt battery. Most people though don't have a multimeter or the confidence to use one, so what can we do instead? This is a situation I was in with my dad recently. He had loads of old batteries he wanted to test, but he didn't have the dexterity to use a multimeter, so I bought him one of these. It's a Nartel LED battery tester. It was only £4 on Amazon. Using it couldn't be any simpler. You simply put the battery you want to test in between the jaws, positive to red, negative to black, and an LED lights up telling you how good the battery is. So that first battery was a new one. This one has been used a little bit, but the voltage is still good. The jaws slide to accommodate different size of batteries, so this is a AAA. You can see that's giving us a yellow LED, so that's on its way out. This tester will accommodate larger C and D cells as well, so we'll take a C cell there. The red LED is showing us that the voltage across this battery is very low, and this is a rechargeable battery, so we can recharge that. This is a D cell. That looks pretty good. These are all 1.5 volt batteries, but you can also use this tester to test 9 volt batteries. There are two connectors on the end. You simply place the terminals of the 9 volt battery against those. You can see this battery is dead. So we'll try a different one. That's much better. That should stop the smoke alarm beeping. You can also test the tiny button cells. But it's not easy if you've got thick fingers like me. Just push it between the jaws. And the green LED is showing us that this cell is good. If a battery is completely flat, none of the LEDs will light up because obviously there's no voltage across the circuit. I've got to say, this battery tester doesn't feel particularly robust, and you need to make sure you don't put anything bigger than 1.5 volts across the jaws, but it does a good job. You can test all the common domestic batteries quickly and easily. And after testing all of these, my initial fears about its longevity were proved wrong. It's absolutely fine, it's still working well. And for what it costs, I think it's a bargain. I'll put an Amazon link in the description below. So I hope you found this video useful. If you have, leave a thumbs up. If you've got any questions, leave a comment below. And don't forget to subscribe to Big Ted's Home and Garden. I'll see you soon.